Hey there, welcome to my channel. Today I have a really cool topic to show you guys. It's called view transitions. If you've never heard about them, or you just don't know how to use them or how they work, today I'll be talking about that. And I'll also be showing you how to use them in Remix and how they work inside of Remix context. So without further ado, let's just jump into it. So, view transitions. Before I actually show you the technical side of things, I just first wanted to show you what they actually are. So if you're one of those developers who like the bleeding edge stuff, you've probably heard about them. But in essence, what they are is basically a very fancy transition between one screen to another with animations. So how it works is, if we look at the example on HTTP 203, if you click any of these videos, they're gonna animate and go to full width, and if you click back here, you're gonna see that they go back into where they were. And if I choose another video and open it, you can see it knows where to start the transition from and where to transition to. So how it works is basically the browser takes like a screenshot of the starting phase and the end phase, and then it merges them together into a smooth transition from one screen to another. And what's really cool about this is the fact that you can use this on your websites today. Even though they're not supported in all browsers, there's always fallbacks that you can use to just transition normally from one page to another. And for the users who actually have the latest versions and this works, they're gonna see some fancy animations. So let's now go to the documentation and let me show you how it actually works. So if you're a Remix developer, your best friend is going to be the MDN web docs. The cool thing about Remix is that it relies on the platform, so you're not gonna need to go to their docs website, but rather the MDN web docs, because most of the things you're gonna be doing is browser-specific stuff that's not specific to Remix in any sort of way. So if you go to MDN web docs and go to the view transition API, you can actually see that it's a really new thing that's not even supported in all the browsers. So Mozilla and Safari don't support it yet at the time of recording. This might change in the future. But the cool thing about it is that it works in Chrome and Edge, and we can see how it looks like on those browsers. So the main concept here is the fact that if you've ever used a SPA before, you know how hard animating any sort of transition from one screen to another is. And you usually have to do some sort of DOM manipulation where you keep the old DOM, you transition to the new one, and then you remove the old one. But you have to make sure that during the transition, the user can't break the animation or do any sort of things that could impact the animation. So these things were really hard to do before, because you just had to do so many things that it was so easy to break it or have bugs in it. And this is where the view transition API comes in. So how it works is, it basically creates a basic view transition, and it transitions from one screen to another using the globally available function on the document. It's called start view transition, and you can see it here. And how it works is, it basically whenever you fire something, so let's say you click a link to another page, you fire the start view transition function, and it's going to take a screenshot of your current page, and then it's going to navigate to the other one. And what's gonna happen is, the browser is gonna take a screenshot of the page that you're navigating to, and it's going to animate the transition from page one to page two. And the really cool thing about this is that it's really simple to do. As you can see, it's a few lines of code here, and it just works, and it's going to animate the transition, and you're gonna be good to go. What this means for us is that we're gonna use this document start view transition inside of Remix, but because Remix does it a little bit differently, we're gonna have a little bit more fun with it, and it's not going to be so low level, it's going to be higher up, because Remix has already provided some really useful utilities for you to actually know where you're transitioning to and how you want to animate it. So basically, you're gonna be able to say, okay, if I'm transitioning to page A or page B, this is how I want to animate it to page A or to page B, or vice versa. If you're going back, I want to animate it like this.
and we're going to be going through that process right now. And how we're gonna do this is basically I've prepared the demo already and it's going to be available in GitHub. I'll just leave it in the description of the video. And I've added a couple of utilities that we're gonna go through right now, and I'll just explain the basic setup. First thing is I've added the Pokemon.ts file, so we're gonna be doing this with Pokemon. I hope you like them. If not, I'm so sorry. I've added a bunch of utilities here to get some information from the Pokemon API. We just want to get the information so we can show what's going on and how we can use view transitions. So there's a bunch of utilities here to basically fetch Pokemon and Pokemon evolutions from their Pokemon API. What I'm gonna be doing in the demo is fetching evolution chains, and then I'm gonna be transitioning between the evolutions of the Pokemon so we can have some fun. And the first important thing is if you go to the root, I've added the header here that's going to be sticky and is going to be on the page at all times. And this is the first thing that I'm going to be using for the view transition API. So if you can see at the link here, it's imported from Remix.run React. And how it works is we add the unstable view transition prop here, and that's pretty much all you have to do to get view transitions in Remix. So what this is going to do is allow you to have view transitions from any page to the slash nothing, basically, so the main page. And how it's gonna work is if you click on this, it's going to start the transition from whatever page you're on to the main page. So I've added four routes here, and the main important one is the index one. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna fetch Pokemon, and we just add a dummy constant here to cache them because we don't want to burden the Pokemon API. And if they're existent in cache, we're gonna return the cache as the JSON, and if not, we're just gonna fetch them and then we're gonna send them to the front end. And the front end is gonna just loop over them, and it's going to create these link and image transition components that I've created. And these are really cool because I'm going to show you how they work. You can actually use them to transition from pages and animate the transitions so that the images change. And let's just start the project now so you can, I can show you what the main page looks like before we go any further with this. All right, so this is our main page, and the cool thing about it is that you can see the evolution chains of all the Pokemon that I fetched from the API. What I wanted to show you is that we have all the cards here, and we want to animate the transition, so whenever we click on one of these Pokemon, it's going to snap into place on the new screen, and it's going to enlarge this card. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna apply the view transition from this Pokemon to another Pokemon on another screen, and they're going to be the exact same ones. So what's gonna happen is they're going to animate smoothly from this screen to another one. So let's first do that part. So what's important to note here is if we go back to the API of the view transitions, we can see this here. So there's a property in CSS called view transition name, and you can pass any sort of name here. And how it works is if you give the name on the first page to an element, you say the Pokemon Pikachu is the first element on the first page that I want to transition to from, and then on the new page, you say, I want this element to also be called Pikachu. What the view transition is going to do is, it's going to say, okay, we have the element on the first page and we have it on the second page. It's the same name. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna move from the element on page A to element on page B. And that's how you can be granular with it and move elements from page A to page B and transition them smoothly. And you can be as granular as you want. You can move text, you can move images, you can move cards, you can move whatever you want, tables. And let's now go back to the code so we can see how we can do this in Remix. Now that we understand how we can do granular transitions, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open this image with transition component that I've created, and we're gonna go through it and what it does. So, because I want to transition images, I've done the following things. I've allowed the props for this component to be anything that the image element takes, so any attributes from the image elements, and I've added the transition name that's required as a string, and I've added the to property so I can know from what page I'm transitioning from to what page. So this allows me to know when the transition is going on and when I should use the view transition name property on the style so I can transition the image from one place to another. So how we can do that is because we provide this to, we're gonna give it to the unstable use view transition state, and at the time of the video this is still unstable, but it might change in the future, so keep that in mind. This might be the use view transition state later on. And we're gonna get this boolean that's gonna tell us that the transition is going on from the page that we're on to the page that we want to transition to with the animation. So if we, let's say, have this sort of animation for 5 pages, but it can happen in 8 ways, it's going to only work for the 5 pages that we provided to it. And what we do is we say when the transition from page A to page B is going on, I want to apply this transition name. So in our Pokemon terms, this will mean when we're going from the main page to the Pokemon page for the specific Pokemon, we will give the view transition name on the main page to the specific Pokemon that we clicked, for example, Pikachu. And then we're gonna have another image on the new page that's also going to have this transition name called Pikachu. And how it's gonna work is the browser is going to say, okay, the Pikachu is located here on the page A, it's located here on the page B, I want to transition between them, and I'm gonna create this transition. So what this allows us to do is the following thing. If you look at the link and image transition component here, this wraps the image with transition component, and what we do here is something really simple. We just allow you to say, okay, I want to transition to this page, so this is our link that's going to use the unstable view transition, and I give it the image as well, and I give it the same to. So what this means is, wherever I'm navigating to, I want to add the image transition to the image as well. So this little utility component allows us to basically transition images in an animated way from page A to page B just by providing the to the link. And then this part here is that we can show the Pokemon name that we're gonna use later on. And on our index page, we have the utility component I was talking about. So these evolutions here are single Pokemon. So if you look at the browser here, so the evolution map is going to be these three Pokemon, then these three, and so on and so forth. So what this means is that each one of these images has the view transition name applied to it as soon as we start the transition from this main page to the Pokemon page. And how it works is, if I click on this, you can see that the Pokemon moved to the new page. And if you click back, it moved back to where it was. So if we click on Venusaur, for example, you can see that it moves over here. And if we click back, it moves to where it was. And that's so cool and so easy to implement, it's not even funny. Now let's go back again to the code, because I wanted to show you something else that I've done. Alright, so now that we're seeing the view transition, let's go over how it actually worked. So here we say, I want to transition to this page, and this will be given to the image as well, and the image is going to use this information to know if you're transitioning to this page, and if you are, it's going to use this transition name to apply it to the image. So whenever you click an image, it's going to give it the view transition name. And because we use this same component on the Pokemon page that we open, you can see it here. It's going to know that this transition name that we apply to the image is the same as it is on the index page, so that we apply here, and it's going to say, okay, I have the transition name on the first page and I have it on the second one, let's transition from that image to this one. And it's really cool because it's so simple to implement. You just give it the same view transition name and it's gonna work. And you don't even have to do this with links. You can just have a normal image here that, that has the same transition name and it's all gonna work. Now I wanna show you another cool example that I've done here on this page, and that's showing the Pokemon info and transitioning that as well. So because I wanted to see how granular I could get, I've prepared this by just allowing you to even go further, and I've added this outlet here. And what it's gonna render is this info page that you can navigate to from the page that we were just in. So whenever you go from the root page to the Pokemon page where you have the evolutions, you can click on the Pokemon on the top and they're gonna transition again to a new page that's going to show their name and also their image. So how we're gonna do that is the same as before. So we're gonna say on this page that we have this image with transition, and the image with transition goes to this link, so to the this route. And what this means is whenever we transition from this route to this one, the transition is going to be true, and then the transition name is going to have the Pokemon name here, so it's going to be the same as on this page, which means we're going to again create a view transition with the image. And how it works is if I click on this Pokemon here, it's going to transition into the page and it's going to enlarge the image and change the name here. And if I click on Bulbasaur, it's going to send Bulbasaur down and then send Ivysaur onto top where it was. And if you can see, whenever I switch from one page to the other one, it's going to change the Pokemon. And that's pretty much all there is to it. You've added view transitions to Remix with basically one line of code.
And that's it for view transitions. I hope you enjoyed this video and had as much fun watching it as I did making it. I love view transitions and I can't wait for them to be stable across all browsers so we can all collectively have fun with them, make NPM packages and do some open source so we can all benefit from them. If you enjoyed this kind of content and want to see more of it, consider subscribing to the channel because I'll be making tons of more Remix content in the near future. Thank you again for watching and see you guys next time. Bye bye!